See, I'm from here. I'm angry because, like, I've been in L.A. For about a year and some change, right? Down there, that cesspool, right? Dealing with it. And I come back up here to record the album, see my mom, you know, and watch how the city's turning into shit, right? And see, you would think that would be me just shitting on all of y'all. And it's not really y'all, it's just the people that look like y'all, you know what I mean? You know what I'm saying? It's like the evil version of this white crowd, you know what I mean? Because I know that y'all come from like West Bumblefuck, you know what I mean? Or Wyoming or something even worse, like Sacramento, you know what I mean? You know? And you come here to work, you know, there's only two types of white people that come to San Francisco. You know, you have your like nonprofit white person. It's always like a brunette, you know what I mean? You know, she comes down here, gets her little sociology degree, right? Works for her nonprofit, like Help the Lesbian Seagull or something, right? You know, just like, did you know 1,000 lesbian seagulls get attacked every year? You know? You get attacked by other, you know, seagulls that don't understand. You know, and it's that white woman. If you work in a nonprofit, you know the kind I'm talking about. She's just annoying but kind of sweet, you know what I mean? She's always bringing like homemade Indian food. It's disgusting. Smells like a river in Pakistan. Everybody's running around. Or she's too busy. She gets Trader Joe's, you know, running around. She drinks tea out of a mason jar, and she always has that breathy NPR, like, did you read the article? You know, kind of around. Did you read it? You know, understanding? Always just interrupting every meeting, you know what I mean? You know, just make it annoying, you know? Get in there. Then she becomes your boss. She's walking around in overalls and shit running around. You know what I mean? Piece of shit, right? Horrible. Then you have your tech white guy. Comes in here, gets his specialized degree, you know what I mean? Or like a guy like you, man. Like, what do you do for a living? Okay, the second part. Okay, I understand the second part. You don't have to be ashamed.
I'm not ashamed.
You scratched your neck. You know what I mean? I mean, I know this club probably has bed bugs. You know what I mean? But you know, it's all right. But you see how they come down, they get the degree, they work at some big ass tech place, like, you know, it's like Uber for cats. You know, you're running around. You know, but then it's stupid. You get it and you come and you think it's gonna be this big cultural exploration, but you guys live in the same neighborhood, the Mission. All you guys just flock to the Mission. But here's the problem. You guys all live in the new Mission. You know what I mean? You guys don't understand it. You guys walk around eating your gentrified burritos. Right? You know, it's like burrito with pad thai in it. Right? And then there used to be culture. Now it's just Chase everywhere. It's a Chase Bank. You know what I mean? Burrito shop, Chase. You know what I mean? Fucking like community center, like a Mexican Chase running around here. El Chase running around. You know what I mean? And you guys have a good time eating your tapas, being assholes, running around drunk at night. Then you run the bar at 1 a.m. and then shit, running around. But see, I was from here. I know when the Mission was scary. It was scary and sexy at the same time. Like a real Latino woman, you know? You're running around. You know, the city with no pockets on his jeans, running around. You know what I mean? Running around. And he just do it, man. Because it would be that thing, because like, if you like the food, y'all eat these burritos, you think they're all nice, it's got grilled vegetables, and it's got tofu and all that. There was no tofu in the 90s. If you order tofu, you get stabbed in your neck, you know what I mean? By the manager of that taqueria, you know what I mean? You know, just run there. If you wanted good Mexican food, you almost had to risk your life. You had to go under the freeway, you know what I mean? In some roach coat, it's got graffiti on it and shit, right? The guy that's making the food's got 80 teardrops on his face running around. The baby's making tortas, you know what I mean? Shit. And you loved it, because you didn't even know what was in that burrito. It could be beef or a ground-up gangbanger, you know what I mean? Shit. But you loved this shit. He was like, because it was authentic. You know what I'm saying? The guy's making your food, he's got fucking tattoos and shit. He's got a wife beater he's sweating through and shit. His low rider is on the side. His whole life is putting that low rider. You know what I mean? He lit this like 18 people in his 2-bedroom apartment, but his car is worth $80,000. It's a goddamn mural on the front. It's like a clown fucking, you know, another clown. You know what I mean? Like a lady clown. You know what I mean? Shit. It's a clown on his dick. You know what I mean? It's like it says El Mission, you know what I mean? It's all dicks, you know, running around. Now you walk around the mission, that same fucking Vato. He's got like a lowrider Prius, you know, running around. A gluten-free churro, and you know, crazy shit. Well, you guys understand that shit.